concert given to you by the Brighouse and Rastrick Brass Band. My name is Russell Gray and I will be the conductor, obviously, for the whole afternoon, and I will be linking the music so that you know what's going on a little bit better than I do later on. So also, I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome our viewers on YouTube who are tuning in and enjoying the concert from the luxury of their own homes. Welcome, and I hope you enjoy the music we have for you today. It's quite a collection of music, very varied, lots of styles. We started this afternoon with music from the pen of Richard Strauss. This was written in the 1940s, and it was actually a present, it was a gift from the composer to the Vienna Council, because he'd been awarded the year before their coveted Beethoven Prize, and he decided to write this as a thank you. It was the Festmusik der Stadt Wien, and it's part of a much larger work. And if you like the little snippet that we started our concert with, I thoroughly recommend that you look it up and listen to the whole work. You won't be disappointed. We're going to continue now with an overture, and it's from the pen of Franz von Suppi. So we're staying in Vienna. He ran an opera house, and of course many of his operas were performed in the mid-19th century. This one is possibly his most famous operetta, and as with most operas, you know that the overture tends to split away from the main body of the work, and it has its own life outside of the opera house, and this is no exception. It's probably played almost every weekend by orchestras all over the world to this day. What overture am I talking about? I'm talking about his Light Cavalry. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Did you enjoy that one? Yes. What a great tune. Isn't it wonderful to be here? What a lovely hall. I like what they've done with the place. So, we're going to change the mood slightly now and go a little bit off track. Have you heard of the American jazz guitarist Pat Metheny? I can tell by the lack of response. A hugely successful artist. He's got at least 20 Grammys to his name and over many, many different categories. And you might think that American jazz guitar music wouldn't particularly suit the genre of brass band. But my learned friend who lives in Bergen in Norway, Sven Henrik Giske, disagrees with that. And he scoured through the entire repertoire and he found this piece. It's the title track of Pat Metheny's sixth solo album. And I'm pretty sure you're going to love this. It's called Letter from Home. Do you all have programs? Could you show me? Can you wave them. It's very warm on you. Just keep going, it's really good. Thanks. So, something fast. This is a little bonbon that Rossini wrote. He wrote many wonderful light music in his soirée musicales. Huge work, lots of wonderful music. And we're going to play for you a dance. It's the eighth movement of his suite, and it's simply called La Danza. Turn to the music of ballet and the composer Sir Arthur Bliss, and he wrote a ballet in 1937 called Checkmate, and this ballet was of course about the game of chess with its ultimate conclusion of the murdering of the Red King by the Black Queen and the plot that goes through the whole ballet is leading to that point. There are many twists and turns, and the Red Knight falls madly in love with the Black Queen, and she doesn't love him, and she turns on him and kills him on the way to killing the king. It's a really happy story. We're going to play a little bit of music from that ballet. It's just before all the blood and guts and gore and all that happens. It's a beautiful piece of writing, and I'm talking about the part of the ballet where the bishops come onto the board and they take center stage. This is the ceremony of the Red Bishops. Nigel, I'm sure you'll agree that's quite stunning music. It's beautiful, beautiful writing. Well, we're going to actually now play our final piece in this first part of our programme before we have a little comfort break. And the band asked me to draw your attention to the programme that you have been given. If you look on the inside of the programme, you'll see that there are various ways in which you can show your support from the band. I know you're already showing support by being here in the first place, but if you want to continue to support the band in the future, there are various ways that you can do it. And also, at the bottom of one of the pages, if you're interested, you can take a look to see what the band's been doing in the last few months, couple of months, while we've been going through this pandemic situation, all the protocols that we've been following and our safety procedures. So if you're interested to take a look at that, please do so. There's also a lottery that you can actually take part in, and you've got a chance of winning some money as well, and the band can benefit from that as also. So in your break, just take a look at that and do with that information what you will. We're going to finish our first spot with a piece of music written, we're staying in the world of ballet. This is written by Joseph Horowitz, who's an Austrian-born composer, but spent the vast majority of his long life residing in England, so really he's a British composer. And he's written over his career 16 ballets, which is quite a lot, that's quite a body of work. And in 1983, he was asked to write a piece for the National Brass Band Championships held every year in October in the Royal Albert Hall in London. So he thought this was a great idea, it's time to write another ballet. Because obviously the band's very agile and you can see that there's fine ballerina type. Tom, yeah? Yeah. So he wrote another ballet for band. This one, however, doesn't actually have dancers as such, but he did say that he had the plot and he had the characters in his mind fully developed at the time that he was writing. But rather than explain that to you, the audience, what he would rather, and he thought it was a little bit of fun, was to not give you any clues. But you'll hear lots of characters going on in this work. I don't think it's a particularly serious ballet, like Checkmate. I think it's a much lighter hearted affair, but that's the only clue you're going to get from me. So he invites you to use your imagination as you're listening to this piece and draw your own conclusions. But you're going to like this. It is a major work. It's about 10 minutes long, and it's longer than most programs that you'd hear at a brass band concert. But I think it's really worth having a listen to, and you can sit back and relax and go through in your head all these visions that you might have. So I invite you to do that as you listen to Joseph Horowitz's Ballet for Band. Thank you. Without acknowledging my roots. So we're going to play a little bit of Scottish music for you. It's from Malcolm Arnold's Four Scottish Dances. And you'll notice the deliberate mistake I'll point it out to you in the programme. It says we're going to play movement three and then movement four. But in actual fact, we're going to play movement three and then movement two. So we're going backwards. But I just think it works this way round. The third movement is beautiful. And I don't know if many of you have had the pleasure of going to Scotland. I'm sure most of you have at some point. If you can now imagine and place yourself standing maybe perhaps on the shores of Loch Lomond and you're looking out onto the water and it's a beautiful day in Scotland. Yes, that means the rain's falling straight down and not into your face. A wonderful day, and this is the scene that we want you to have in your head when you're listening to the third movement. And then we're going to go to the second movement, which is a reel. Same sort of tune going round and round in very different keys. And if you're listening very, very carefully, you might just spot a rather inebriated bass trombone. promises me he's not been drinking, but we'll see what happens. Steve, you all right there? So we're going to play, and oh, by the way, if you want to clap between the two movements, then that's perfectly okay. Just a subtle hint there.
Thank you.
So in this half of our programme, we're going to feature some of the soloists in the band, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to our principal cornet, Tom Smith, who hails from Cornwall. And are you still studying at the RNCM? Wow, one more year. Well, he's obviously working very, very hard, because he sounds absolutely fabulous, and you enjoyed that solo in the Four Scottish Dances. Well, we're going to feature you now playing a beautiful solo from the Salvation Army repertoire. It's called Don't Doubt Him Now. Will you please welcome to play this the Brighouse and Rastrick's principal cornet, Tom Smith.
Thank you.
bright future. Well, our next soloist is Tom Hall, featuring a percussion solo. It's a xylophone solo. What's funny about that? Where are you going? What's the plan? You're going over there. Talk amongst yourselves. This solo is from composer Jan Berejka. It's a great name from the Midlands. He's from Leamington. He spent a lot of time in Birmingham his entire career. In fact, he was so famous in Leamington that there was a street named after him when he passed. You're stunned at that piece of information, aren't you? Brighouse and Rastrick, if anybody's interested. And this solo, he was a big band leader. Don't worry about him, he's fine, he will follow. He was a big band leader in the 30s and 40s, and this is probably one of his most famous pieces. I'll tell you a little bit about Tom. He's a furniture removal expert. He was a finalist in the BBC Young Musician of the Year. And he's got a wonderful smile. A very silly haircut. So, to play Taps in Tempo, please welcome Tom Hall.
Thank you.
heard of this, though, but you will know this. This was a piece that actually spent 5 weeks at number one when it came out in the charts in the 1920s. I think it was written 25. But it was adopted by the Harlem Globetrotters, really New York-based basketball team. And I think that's probably what made it famous. This is a fantastic arrangement for a brass band by Goff Richards. And I'm talking about Sweet Georgia Brown. This one is from the 8th movie, 1973. This is the one where James Bond sees himself being sent to New York to chase drug lords and voodoo masters. And I think there was a certain tarot card reader as well, or in the way as well. and they met some crocodiles in the Caribbean islands. So this, I'm talking about Live and Let Die, the theme tune written by Paul and Linda McCartney and their group Wings, and a real classic. It's been arranged for bands, and to play it for us, going to be a soprano chorus solo. We've got one of the safest soprano players in the country, Martin Irwin, is going to stand and play for us. Will you please welcome Martin to play Live and Let Die? An international reputation, but I won't tell you what for. I said to him, what are you going to play this Sunday at our concert? And he's done this arrangement himself for today. Tarantella, which, as you know, is a dance that you do to get rid of a disease. Sometimes you can dance yourself to death on a tarantella. You're not going to do that today, though, are you? No. It's called La Napolitaine. Did we get that right? To play it for you, the band's principal euphonium, Chris Robertson.
Thank you.
practices. Wonderful playing, really, it's truly tremendous, wonderful. So, yes, why not? If you've enjoyed the concert today, I hope you have, and I hope we get to do more of this more often. You might be interested in a couple of engagements that are in the band's diary. They're not so far from here, actually. The first one is the 4th of September. It's a 3 p.m. concert, and it's in the Victoria Theatre in Halifax, which is just down the road, isn't it? And if you can't make that one, you might want to put in your diary Friday the 17th of December, which is an evening concert, and it's pretty close to Christmas, so I think I can guess what the concert's theme's going to be. And it's actually in here. So put that in your diary, the 17th of December, and you'll enjoy the Christmas concert then. So we come to our final piece of finale, and we've chosen the pen of Otto Respighi for this one. And it starts, I want you to use your imagination again, I want you to imagine you're standing in the centre of Rome, and in the distance you can hear the footsteps approaching very deliberately of the Roman army. They've just been on campaign, and of course they've been successful, because they always were. And they're coming home triumphantly, and you're waiting for them to arrive at the gates of the Senate. And it's very, very early morning. It's just before dawn, and there's a very, very gentle breeze, and the pines on the Appian Way are blowing gently in the wind, and the sound gets bigger and bigger and bigger all the way to the end. And when you think the band's playing about as loud as it possibly could play, it gets louder and just keeps going. They've been known to do damage to big buildings, break windows, but I think you'll be okay. I apologise to you sitting in the front, you've been very polite to sit there, you might regret it now. Please enjoy our finale. It's the March from the Pines of Rome by Respighi. Oh, heads up, if you clap really loud at the end of this, we might stay for more. finish the programme the way we started it in Vienna. And this one, he used to conduct his own orchestra, these gigs with his brother. He would alternate. Sometimes those engagements, they would dance 50 dances in an evening. And he always had an eye for the ladies. So what he liked to do was to set his orchestra off, and then he would disappear into the dance floor and eventually turn up sometime later and stop his orchestra. And he used to use a device called perpetuum mobile, which is a little piece that doesn't have an end. It just keeps going until you run out of steam. So we're going to play for you a little piece by Johann Strauss. It's great fun. It's a little 8-bar theme that goes around in variations and features the entire band. And we'll leave you with that. So thank you so much for being here and joining this concert with the Brighouse and Rastrick Band. We do hope you've enjoyed it, and we will see you again real soon. This is Perpetuum Mobile by Strauss. Thank you very much, and good evening. So this is where we have a problem, because there isn't an ending to the piece. Now, I didn't tell you that the band is actually going to be here until the 17th of December, where you can enjoy the Christmas concert. So I'll look forward to then. Thank you so much. Sit comfortably, and I'll see you in a couple of months.